Hi, welcome to the Semantics lectureette on Predicate Abstraction. This lectureette will just go over when to use the rule and how to use it. So let's get started. So for an example, we can look at a simple sentence like this. I saw everyone, done in the Hyman-Kretzer style, with simple sentences and a woefully antiquated syntax. When do you use predicate abstraction? You use it when there is movement and when there is binding. And in this case, you end up with both because quantifier raising requires them both. And so the abstraction will do is allow us to create properties and link expressions at one part of the structure to another part of the structure by manipulating the assignment function. So if we build this sentence in a straightforward fashion, and we use the assignment G, then the denotation of this sentence here would be something like this of type T. And this is a finished proposition. So how do we unfinish it so that we can plug it into everyone? Okay. And that's where abstraction comes in. So we start with that. And we move on to this abstraction and we look at this bit right here. So we have lambda 2, lambda sub 2, and we have saw g of 2 and I, right? And so when we get a structure like this, this is when we use predicate abstraction. There's an index that will serve as a binder, and there is an expression that has the same index in it. That's a key bit. Otherwise, we're abstracting in vain, and we don't want to be doing that. Now, the abstraction process itself will actually consist of four steps, right? There is abstraction, the value copy, the assignment modification, and the conversion. And you walk through them and we end up with the right result. And once you get the hang of it, you can just go straight to the end. So the first part is the abstraction itself. We add a lambda expression that will be of the same type of the variable we're targeting, in this case, type E. So something like this. That's abstraction one. Now we copy the value. That is to say, this entire expression, we'll copy it. And at this point, we haven't done a whole lot, but that's the second step. The third step is we modify the assignment. That is, instead of G, we're gonna have G, but modified so that 2 points to our variable here. So we can write this again. And so instead of G, we get G so that 2 points to X, 2 maps to X of 2. So whatever this assignment was, now anytime we have 2, it's going to turn into X, right? And that's our modification. That's the heart of the rule. Then we can convert, because we can plug this in and apply it. When you plug in 2, you get x. So we can now replace this whole thing with x. Lambda x in d sub e. Saw x of I. And now we have an expression of the right type. And we know that whenever we plug this in to everyone, that this is who gets seen. So one thing that people often mess up is abstraction when there's already a lambda expression in the value, right? So we're abstracting in this case over a property of events. In this case, I see G of 2. Again, maybe for quantification. Now abstraction does not care what's here, what type it is or anything. So it could be a simple type like we saw, it could be a complex type like this. The rule will be exactly the same. You need an index in there somewhere. So how does this work? Remember, first step, abstract over the same type. Lambda x, d sub e, there you go. Second step, copy the value. That means all of it, including the lambda expression. Lambda e, and d sub s, and then this, c, g of 2, I, E, right? And this works out exactly the same way, and we'll end up just adding it. So we don't lose any arguments here. That's the key bit. You don't want to lose anything you had. We're just adding an argument. Then we modify. So we'll write this again. C, G, two maps to X of two, I of E. And since mapping two, since G now maps two to X and we're plugging in two, we can replace that with X and we get our result. And the X in D sub E and the E in D sub S, C, X, I of E. And that's of type EST. And we have our expression. We have our result. And now the abstraction works just the same way. Same method. You just have to remember not to lose anything as you add.